وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، last week we started a series where we were speaking about the concept of Islamic finance, Islamic income or halal income, and I gave an introduction last Friday. Inshallah, today we're going to speak about earning in Islam, its types, its levels, and its virtues. So we're going to speak about income. How many types are there? Its levels, and also its virtues, inshallah ta'ala. So what is the word kasb? Kasb in the Arabic language, what does it mean? The word kasb. Kaf, seen, ba. What does it mean? A three-letter word. It means تحصيل نفع أو ضر. It is to attain, it is to earn something that is beneficial or something that is harmful. That's what the word kasab means. It is to earn something that is beneficial or something that's very harmful. Let's break that down, inshallah ta'ala. The thing that the person earns can be something beneficial for their dunya and their hereafter. So maslaha dunyawiyya or a maslaha ukhrawiyya or a maslaha for both. A benefit that you gain for this dunya and a benefit for the hereafter. And the benefit can sometimes be obligatory. Meaning you have to earn this. It's obligatory for you to earn it. The ulama mentioned for a person to make income for their need is obligatory. You to make the amount that you need to survive is obligatory. For instance, you're an individual, you're alone, you're not married, you have no children. Maybe even your parents are not alive. So you're alone. You have to make the amount that is obligatory for you to survive. Now, can you do it on a day-to-day basis? For instance, I work today, only what I need today, you can. You go, you make the provision and the amount needed for that day, and then you close your shop and you leave. And some of the Salaf, they used to do this. Some of the early scholars, they only used to make the amount that they needed for that day. And after that, they will go and seek knowledge. Or they will go and do ibadah. Tomorrow they come again, they work for what is needed for that day again, and then they leave. But if you're a person who others are connected to you, you've got a wife, you've got children, then you are obliged to make money for yourself and for those who are connected to you. So you can't just say, I'm just making enough for myself. You are obliged to make an amount for yourself and an amount for your family members that are connected to you, your wife and your children, etc. It's obligatory, it's wajib. Again, those who are connected to you, you can make for them what they need on a day-to-day basis, you can. For instance, you bring what is needed for that day to your wife and your children and your parents, and you don't have anything for them tomorrow, and then you go out tomorrow to make what is needed for tomorrow, وَهَلُمَّ جَرَّى, and it goes on like that, it's permissible for you. As long as you what? As long as you make what is needed by those who are connected to you. If you have debt, and you have to pay that debt off, you're also obliged to make the amount required for that debt as well. So you can't just say, I make enough for myself, and I make enough for my wife and children, and then I what? But I don't have money to pay off that debt. You have to find another job, find another earning to pay off that debt. It's obligatory. This is the qadr which is wajib, the amount that is obligatory. Anything other than that is mustahab, it's recommended. In other words, are you allowed to make money for the whole entire year? Yes, you are. Can you collect money for a year, for 2 years? Na'am, you're allowed to. Nabi Muhammad's life is divided into two. A first portion of his life, he only used to make what he needed for that day. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Whatever he needed for that day, that's how much he had, alayhi salatu wasalam. And he didn't have anything other than that. But if you look at late stages of his life, alayhi salatu wasalam, he started to have storage. He had what? He had storage. He had that which he needs for the whole entire year. Okay? And that shows us that both of them are, they're both permissible. They're both permissible. ولذلك الإمام الترمذي narrated in his Sunan من حديث سلمة بن عبيد الله بن محسن الحضمي رحمه الله أما الخطمي sorry عن أبيه وكانت له صحبة محسن بن الخطمي sorry عبيد الله بن محسن الخطمي was a companion. He said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said من أصبح منكم آمنا في سربه. Anyone who has been given safety in his household, he's got safety, alhamdulillah. He wakes up and he's nothing to be scared of. He's got security and safety. مُعَافًا فِي جَسَدِهِ, and he has a healthy body. He's not sick. He has a healthy body. مُعَافًا فِي جَسَدِهِ. The Prophet then said, عِنْدَهُ قُوتُ يَوْمِهِ, and he has his daily requirements. The Prophet restricted to what? He has what he needs for the day. عِنْدَهُ قُوتُ يَوْمِهِ. He has the amount that he needs for that day. The food and the provision he needs for that day, he has it. The Prophet said, فَكَأَنَّمَا حِيزَتْ لَهُمُ الدُّنْيَا بِحَذَافِيرِهَا. It is like the whole entire universe has been placed under your feet. You have health. You have safety and security. And you also have your daily need. Not your weekly need or your monthly requirement, but daily. It's like the whole entire universe, and the whole entire world has been placed under your feet. So this hadith, the scholars, they took from it that the bare minimum that a person needs is what? Daily. Daily need. So you have to make what you need for that day. It's obligatory. That's the first part of the definition of the word kasb, income, earning. We said that it means tahsinu naf'in, it's to gain something good. And we spoke about the good, there is that which is obligatory, and there is amount, there is a part of it that which is recommended. The benefit, kasb means tahsinu naf'in, it is to earn good. And it's also to earn evil, right? That's what the word kasb means. And the good, I said, it's what? ما هو واجب, that which is obligatory. And ما هو مستحب, and that which is recommended. I also mentioned that the good that you're earning can be good in this dunya and the good in the hereafter. Now I'm going to go to the second part, which is تحصيل ضر, earning harm. Which is part of the definition. Allah تبارك وتعالى, He showed us in the Quran that a person can earn evil. And he used the word kasb for evil. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَكْسِبْ إِثْمًا فَإِنَّمَا يَكْسِبْهُ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. Allah said in this ayah, وَمَنْ يَكْسِبْ إِثْمًا, anyone who earns ithm, which is sinning, evil. It's very broad, like what he's earning here can be evil actions, it can be haram income. وَمَنْ يَكْسِبْ إِثْمًا فَإِنَّمَا يَكْسِبُهُ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ. He's doing this to himself. He's earning this haram for himself. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ, and Allah is عَلِيمًا, one who has deep knowledge of what you're doing. The haram you're earning, other people may not know. But Allah is alim, He knows it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And hakeem, and Allah is wise. Wise in how He is dealing with you right now, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in another ayah, وَمَنْ يَكْسِبْ خَطِيئَةً أَوْ إِثْمًا ثُمَّ يَرْمِي بِهِ بَرِيئًا فَقَدْ احْتَمَلَ بُهْتَانًا وَإِثْمًا مُبِينًا. Allah says, وَمَنْ يَكْسِبْ خَطِيئَةً أَوْ إِثْمًا. Anyone who earns خَطِيئَة and إِثْم. What's the difference between the two? خَطِيئَة means mistake, unintentional, didn't intend it, but it's wrong. Something wrong that you're earning. You're earning haram income, but you don't know what you're earning. You see? Oh, ithma means ta'ammad al-sayyi'ah, ta'ammad al-ma'asiyah. The person intended the evil. Allah says, ثُمَّ يَرْمِي بِهِ بَرِيئًا. And then what He does is that the evil that he earned and the wrongdoings that he came with, He accuses other people of it. فَقَدْ احْتَمَلَ. This person has put on his shoulders بُهْتَانًا وَإِثْمًا مُبِينًا. He has taken on his shoulders a great sin, and he has falsified a great amount. That's what the ayah says. Also, Allah says in another ayah, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٍ. There is no calamity that befalls you except it has come from what? بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. So we've learnt now that the word kasb, which is earning, can be good and it can also be what? It can also be bad. We're going to come into great details what haram income is, what are the principles that we can know that this is an income is haram or not. It's going to come. It's part of the series. But we want to define it and have an understanding of it. Brothers and sisters who are listening, earning is a daruriyatun fitriyatun wa daruriyatun diniyah. Earning is a necessary, innate thing that's built into us, in us. Going out of our ways to get income and making money, it's something Allah has placed inside us. It's a daruriyatun fitriyah. It's a necessary component of us. And it's also a what? Daruriyatun diniyatun. And even the sharia also gives it a necessary. So it's not just something the humans want to do, but it's also something that the religion emphasizes on greatly. So our religion is not like you tend to find many people who believe, inshallah, Allah is going to bring me rizq and I'm just going to stay in the masjid. I'm not going to work and put hard work in. This really goes against what the religion stands on. And it goes against our deen, and you'll see it inshallah ta'ala. Allah said in the ayah, and this is in the context of, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ فَاسْعُوا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعَ ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Allah says, فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ, if the salah is over and it's finished, the jum'ah has been done, the khutbah has been done, the salah has been prayed. فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ فَانْتَشِرُوا, disperse on the earth and do what? وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ, look for the Fadl of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Look for the Fadl of Allah means here, go and look for the rizq that Allah has placed on this earth. Go and earn. Exert effort in. And then look what Allah said after that. وَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. And some of the scholars, they took from that earning halal income, which we're going to see in another ayah, is a way to remember Allah in a good way. It's a means. The ayah says, look for the provisions. وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ. مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ is that which is halal. وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا, and remember Allah a lot. The relationship between halal income and the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jalla. That this would lead to this. This would what? It will lead to this. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala emphasized that same point I just mentioned in another ayah. Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those of you who believe in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, أَنْفِقُوا, give, which is a righteous action, right? But Allah says, مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Give from the halal earnings that you make. وَمِمَّا أَخْرَجْنَا لَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ, and that which we have brought from the earth from you. So giving, which is a form of remembering Allah Azza wa Jalla, comes through what? Halal? Halal earning and halal income. Rather, brothers, the concept of going out and working and earning halal income is even greater than al-jihad fi sabilillah. It is greater than what? Al-jihad fi sabilillah. To go and fight in the cause of Allah and to go out and make a halal income, it is actually greater to go out and make halal income. Did you guys know that? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the ayah, إِنَّ رَبَّكَ يَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ تَقُومُ أَدْنَى مِنْ ثُلُثَيِ اللَّيْلِ وَنِصْفَهُ وَثُلُثَهُ وَطَائِفَةٌ مِنَ الَّذِينَ مَعَكَ وَاللَّهُ يُقَدِّرُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ عَلِمَ أَنْ لَنْ تُحْصُوهُ فَتَابَ عَلَيْكُمْ فَاقْرَؤُوا مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ عَلِمَ أَنْ سَيَكُونُ مِنْكُمْ مَرْضَى وَآخَرُونَ يَبْتَغُونَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَآخَرُونَ يَضْرِبُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَبْتَغُونَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَآخَرُونَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَاقْرَؤُوا مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنْهُ. Allah tells us here, وَآخَرُونَ يَبْتَغُونَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَآخَرُونَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَآخَرُونَ يَضْرِبُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَبْتَغُونَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَآخَرُونَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Allah mentioned a portion of them are going out to look for the provision of Allah, and then Allah after mentions, and from them are those who are going to fight in the cause of Allah. Allah put first those who are making the halal income before the one who fights in the cause of Allah. And look what Umar took from this. Umar said this. رضي الله تعالى عنه. Sa'id ibn Mansur, Abd ibn Humayd, and ibn Mundhir, they bought it on the tafsir of this ayah. That Umar رضي الله عنه said, لَأَنْ أَمُوتَ بَيْنَ شُعْبَتَيْ رَحْلِي. For me to die between my merchandise. Umar رضي الله عنه, فاروق هذه الأمة. For me to die, Umar said, for me, Umar ibn al-Khattab, to die in between my merchandise, my products, my merchants that I'm trying to make money from. For me to die, بين شعبتي رحلي أضرب في الأرض, and I'm out on the earth trying to make risk and provision for myself. أبتغي من فضل الله, and I'm looking for the virtue of Allah. أحب إلي is more beloved to me من أن أقتل مجاهدا في سبيل الله تعالى. Than to be killed in the cause of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. لأن الله قدم الذين يضربون في الأرض. Because Allah gave precedence to the ones who are going out on the earth and are earning halal income. على المجاهدين. Than those who are fighting in the cause of Allah. And then he read the ayah. وآخرون يضربون في الأرض يبتغون من فضل الله وآخرون يجاهد وآخرون يقاتلون في سبيل الله. This shows us, brothers, what? The virtue of the one who goes out to earn income and make money for himself, but in a halal way. His aim and objective is what? His aim and his objective is to make sure that what he's earning and what he's making is halal and it's not a haram. And the ulama mentioned the evidence in the ayah to show that the one who's earning the halal income is better than the one who's fighting in the cause of Allah. It's the taqdeem. That the fact that Allah put this one before this one. And not always is that the case, but the fact Umar understood it from that shows us it is the case now. Now.
But the death of a jahid, right? Shaheed, right? The death of a merchant is also the same.
Even though they are both martyrs, and many other characteristics are martyrs, lakin halat al-talab. The time that they are both going out before they die, both of them, whilst they are going out to earn the pleasure of Allah, who is more virtuous? You see, the scholars, they took from this that the one who's earning money and making money for himself, whilst he's going out to make the money, he's more virtuous than the one who goes out in the cause of Allah in the desert and walks. That's one. Number two, the one who's going out to make halal income is better than the mujahid, even if the mujahid dies. And this person doesn't die. And there are many of the Salaf who believe that. Rahimahumullah. Number one being Umar radiallahu anhu. This really shows us that our religion, it's about the concept of going out and making yourself an income. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he showed us in the Quran that the first person to go out and make a earning for themselves was Nabiullah Adam alayhi salam. Adam was the first individual to bring this concept into play, to work, to earn an income for himself was Adam alayhi salam. And the evidence for that, many people don't tend to see it, is قوله تعالى, is the statement of Allah, فَقُلْنَا يَا آدَمُ إِنَّ هَذَا عَدُوٌ لَكَ وَلِزَوْجِكَ فَلَا يُخْرِجَنَّكُمَا مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ فَتَشْقَى. This in Allah said, we said to Adam that Iblis is an enemy to you and your wife. فَلَا يُخْرِجَنَّكُمَا, do not let him take you both out of Jannah. فَتَشْقَى. What does it mean, فَتَشْقَى? The Mufassirin like Sudi, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Mujahid ibn Jabril, the great Imams of Tafsir, they said فَتَشْقَى here means فَتَتْعَبَى, that you get tired. Meaning if Iblis takes you out of Jannah, you're going to come to the earth and you're going to have to make for yourself an income. You're going to get tired of making money. أي تَتْعَبُ فِي طَلَبِ الرِّزْقِ, you'll become tired from going onto this earth and making for yourself a what? An earning. That's not what you do in Jannah. Jannah, you don't work for anything. Everything is given to you. You've already worked for it. Like the dunya, you go and you exert effort in and you make a livelihood for yourself. Like what amazed me from the ayah is, Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَقُلْنَا يَا آدَمُ إِنَّ هَذَا عَدُوُ لَكَ وَلِزَوْجِكَ فَلَا يُخْرِجَنَّكُمَا مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ فَتَشْقَى. And Allah did not say, فَتَشْقَيَا. It only spoke to Adam at the last part. When in the beginning it was talking to who? It was talking to both of them. إِنَّ هَذَا عَدُوُ لَكَ وَلِزَوْجِكَ, this is an enemy to you and your wife, both of them. But then at the end, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, فَتَشْقَى, because the earning and the hard work of making a livelihood is upon the man, not the woman. Allah is talking to Adam alayhi salam. وَلِذَلِكَ بَغَوِيُّ, he said, وَلَمْ يَقُلْ فَتَشْقَيَا رُجُوعًا بِهِ إِلَىٰ آدَمَ لِأَنَّ تَعَبَهُ أَكْثَرُ فَإِنَّ الرَّجُلَ هُوَ السَّاعِي عَلَىٰ زَوْجَتِهِ. Al-Imam al-Baghawi said that فَتَشْقَيَا was not used in the verse. Allah did not talk to Adam or Hawa, both of them at the same time. Allah spoke to only Adam. Why? Because the ta'ab and the making of the rizq and earning and making money is upon who? The man. He is the one who provides for his spouse, his partner. And we know, brothers, that making a livelihood, a halal livelihood, for yourself and your family is something that requires ta'ab and hard work. ولذلك مجاهد, he said, لا تأكل خبزا بزيت حتى تعمل عملا إلى الموت. Mujahid said that you will not, he's talking about the most basic food that one can eat, which is what? A bread and an oil, or olive oil or whatever. As basic as that. A bread and an oil, both of them, you can't eat it, he said. حتى تعمل, until you work and work that will reach you close to what? إلى الموت, death. You see? Meaning this is the ta'ab and the hard work that is exerted in making it. You may not have to make the bread, and yes, you may not have to bring the olive oil and make it and produce it, like you're going to have to make the money from it, right? That means you wake up in the morning, you go out, you sometimes even forget to eat. وما إلى ذلك. سرخسي رحمه الله, سرخسي, he mentions in his kitab Al-Mabsut fi Fiqh Al-Hanafi. All the previous prophets, brothers, they worked. Nabiullah Nuh, it was said, كان نجارا يأكل من كسبه. Nabiullah Nuh was a carpenter and he used to eat from his own work, his own provision. These are anbiya, these are prophets of Allah. They didn't make money and they didn't make their life to charge people for their da'wah and their deen. That's not what they did. What they did was, they had their own working. In the Quran, if you look, what did they say? قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِمْ أَجْرًا. I'm not going to ask you for any rizq. I don't want anything from you guys. إِنْ أَجْرِيَ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ. My reward is with who? Is with Allah Azza wa Jalla. So Nuh كان نجارا. Nabiullah Nuh was a carpenter. يأكل من كسبه, he will eat from what he made. Idris كان خياطا. Idris was a tailor. He used to make tailor clothes. Ibrahim كان بزارا. Ibrahim used to take clothings that were tailored and he would go to the market and he would sell it. So he used to sell clothings. Zakaria كان نجارا also. Zakaria was also a carpenter. عيسى عليه السلام ربما كان يلتقط السنبلة فيأكل من ذلك وهو نوع اكتساب. عيسى عليه السلام لكن was slightly different from the rest. عيسى would go on the earth and he would look for the corns, the sweet corns. Sometimes there will be sweet corns on there. He would take what's on there from the earth and he would collect that and he would eat that instead of begging anyone, asking anyone to give him anything. Like in Nabila, Isa was Zahid, more aesthetic, more far from. But look what he said, وَهُوَ نَوْعُ اكْتِسَابٍ. It was a form of his earning. That's how he used to make it. Sulaiman alayhi salam, it was said, كَانَ يَسْلَعُ الْمَكَاتِلَ. Sulaiman used to make, makatil is the hand-weaved carpets that people sit on. They take it from trees and they make it from it. It's not actual carpet, but it's those handmade ones. He used to make that. وَيَأْكُلُ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. And he would sell it and make money from it. Sulaiman was who, ya ikhwa? Allah said in the Quran, وَحُشَرَ لِسُلَيْمَانَ جُنُودُهُ مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنْسِ وَالطَّيْرِ فَهُمْ يُوزَعُونَ. The wind, the jinn, the ins, the birds, the insects, they all worked for him. But he also had a job. Sulaiman, he used to make money on the side. Dawood kana yasna'u dir'a. Dawood used to make an armor out of metal. Because Allah told us in the Quran that Nabilah Dawood, he was a person just like, you know, the ajin. What's the ajin called? You put the bread and the yeast when you add it together and you want to make yourself khubz or whatever, the way it's soft. That's the dough, yeah, na'am. That's how it was for Nabilah Dawood, the metal. He'll take the metal and he could bend it and carve it. Allah told us in the Quran, وَأَلَنَّا لَهُ الْحَدِيدِ. And Dawood alayhi salam was Khalifa on this earth. As Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا خَلِيفَةً فِي الْأَرْضِ. Dawood, we have made you a governor on this earth. مَعَ ذَلِكَ he had an income on the side that he used to make. Just because he was the lead of the Muslims, he didn't take money from that. He left that money for the people. And he made for himself a rizq on the side. And Allah told us in the Quran, وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ صَنْعَةَ لَبُوسٍ لَكُمْ لِتُحْسِنَكُمْ مِنْ بَأْسِكُمْ فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ شَاكِرُونَ. Nabi Allah Dawood, we taught him, وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ صَنْعَةَ لَبُوسٍ. We taught him how to make the armor. So they had crafts, skills that they used, these prophets. And I asked myself, in this famous hadith, Al-Imam al-Bukhari narrated on the authority of Al-Miqdad ibn Ma'di Karibin, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Prophet said in this hadith, I'm going to get the benefit out of it, he said, مَا أَكَلَ أَحَدٌ طَعَامًا قَطٌ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ مِنْ عَمَلِ يَدِيهِ وَإِنَّ النَّبِيَّ اللَّهِ دَاوُدَ عَلَيْهِ سَمْ كَانَ يَأْكُلُ مِنْ عَمَلِ يَدِيهِ. The Prophet said, there is not a person who eats a rizq better than what he makes from his own hand. The best form of earning, the best form of provision and food is that which you worked for. That which you strived for and you earned it. وَإِنَّ نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ دَاوُودِ. And نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ دَاوُودِ عليه السلام كَانَ يَأْكُلُ مِنْ عَمَلِ يَدِهِ. And Dawood used to make his own income. And he would eat from that. Here the question is, all these prophets used to work, as we mentioned, all of them. What? Why was Dawood specified? And why was he mentioned from the rest? Ibn Hajar rahimahullah mentioned in his kitab Fathul Bari, which is a sharh of Sahih al-Bukhari, he said, وَالْحِكْمَةُ فِي تَخْصِيصِ دَاوُودِ بِالذِّكْرِ أَنَّ اقْتِصَارَهُ فِي أَكْلِ عَلَى مَا يَعْمَلُهُ بِيَدِهِ لَمْ يَكُنْ مِنَ الْحَاجَةِ لِأَنَّهُ كَانَ خَلِيفَةً فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى وَإِنَّمَا ابْتَغَى الْأَكْلَ مِنْ طَرِيقِ الْأَفْضَلِ. Dawood alayhi salam, the reason why and the wisdom why he was specified is because he never worked because he needed income. Dawood was wealthy, very wealthy, had money, a lot. His whole world was under his, Allah gave him it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so Dawood didn't work because he needed to work. But he worked because what? He worked because he believed this was more virtuous. This was greater. That you go out there and you make your own income. You work for it, you strive for it, you exert your effort, and you get your rizq from there. وَإِنَّمَا بَتَغَى الْأَكْلَ مِنْ طَرِيقِ الْأَفْضَلِ He chose this way because it's what? Because it's the best way. So what we've taken today is the types of kasb there are, that which is obligatory and that which isn't. We've also taken that the kasb is either benefits that you're going to bring yourself or harm. We also took that the kasb can be in this dunya or in the hereafter. We also spoke about the levels of incomes. Like Nabi Lai Dawood was a najjar. His profession was different from the profession of what? Of مثلاً Nabi Lai Ibrahim or Nabi Lai Idris. Because Idris was a khayyat, he was a tailor. And we also studied the virtue of earning and making your own provision. I want to stop there inshallah ta'ala for today's session. As I said to you, it's meant to be maximum 45 minutes. 30 minutes to 45 minutes inshallah ta'ala. It's just meant to be basic, small, summarized, concise silsila series inshallah ta'ala. And next week we'll take inshallah ta'ala another portion like that. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan. And Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله استغفرك وأتوب إليك